That's him. So listen to this April the 20th date. And then the fact that Dominic Breazeale is involved, so which means Al Heyman's involved. Yes, Justin. Thank you, Al Heyman. Can we get a thank you, Al Heyman, in the chat? Let's listen to this little part right here. Then we're going to fast forward all the way to the Eddie Hearn part right here. Yeah, because Alvarez is an Al Heyman fighter.
Out.
Yay!
You happy with April the 20th?
Yep.
Is that enough time?
Yep. I started training. I think it's 12 or 13 weeks from now. So yeah, it's enough time for me to get myself into shape and crack on.
The opponents that have been named as potential opponents are...
How do you know this? Who told you this?
Eddie Hearn.
See, Eddie likes talking too much too quick. That's why these fights don't get made, because you have to agree these fights before you start talking.
You're putting out potential names, but we can guess these names anyway.
These guys have put their prices up, man, and these fights won't get made.
But Dylan, we can probably guess the names anyway.
Yeah, but you guessing them and Eddie and saying them is two different things.
All right, he's putting names out there. Povetkin, Brazil, Ortiz, correct? One of them?
Whoever won it can have it.
Who do you want out of those three then?
I don't care, man. I'll fight anyone.
Would the fight with Brazil be a final eliminator for...
That's the plan. We're trying to get the WBC to agree a few things. If they agree, then that's the fight.
Where are you in the WBO? Like, what's
number
the situation?
One.
Right, so are they calling...
Number one, baby! Number one!
Who I am?
No, you're number two.
What's the situation regarding that? Because...
I don't know what's going on. You have to say, Eddie Hearn is the billion-dollar baby, so... Let's see what he says, man. Let's just speak to him. I don't know. He's my promoter. He just needs to deliver for me.
So, did you notice that how they glanced over the WBC situation? That they're talking to the that they're talking to the WBC about you know, a few things in regarding to sanctioning Whyte versus Breazeale. Once again, Breazeale, Al Heyman fighter. Right? The WBO, it really doesn't seem like he wants to go that route.
In it, you know, obviously I understand he's in a bad situation because is it me, he's got Joshua, and Joshua's dictating to him and I'm dictating to him. He works for both of us, so I understand Eddie Hearn is in a bad position. I understand, you know, he needs to deliver, but he needs to fucking deliver, innit? Simple as that. He needs to just deliver. Get rid of the short trousers and deliver. You know he says with short trousers on his feet. Why is that? Good fight. Yeah, man, what, people won't complain. People just want to see good fights. The four best fighters. Might switch it up. So let's see.
So, hello, mate. All right. Okay, so you've obviously got stuff going on behind the scenes, but it's from this side very unclear about what is going to happen with you, with Joshua, with anyone.
It's a fantastic four. Let's get it.
A fight with you and Anthony Joshua will happen at some point this year, in the second part of the year, maybe.
Well, if I stay undefeated and he stays undefeated, then let's see. You know, Miller might trip and fell and fall on him and break his back. You know, and he might lose it by DQ or something or whatever. If he hits Miller, Miller comes forward and he hits him and Miller...
In the fights that we're talking about...
Yeah. He's a mess. He's a mess, and reinforced the floorboarding with the iron boy. I don't know. Listen, he might just break the floor. He is fucking.
Oh, big. Hello. Come here. Come here.
Oh,
great timing.
You know, he was hiding right there.
Hiding around the corner. Hello.
What?
Congrats.
How are you? Well done, Felix.
Well done.
Congratulations.
Good performance.
Oh, we were just talking about you.
Wait, is it good or what?
I think Dylan's words were, Eddie's got to fucking deliver.
Yeah, I've delivered this whole career. So, in fact, they should call me the fucking postman, to be honest.
We need the jewel, son. We need the jewel.
I deliver. and you've delivered because you've gone from six rounds.
April.
Yeah, I think, I mean, he's on pay-per-view. So depending on what pay-per-views are happening when, you want 4 or 5 weeks between them. So
is 20th your first option?
Probably. I think it's a perfect pay-per-view date. But obviously, we've got to get the right fight. We've got to build the right card. And, you know, Dillian and his team are involved in, have been involved in doing that consistently in the last two fights. So we've already been talking about fights for the undercard. We've probably got 3 or 4 crackers that would...
Man, get to the point.
But I don't think... He's never wanted to wait around. He's never...
We do great business. Once the rules is rolling, it's great. But sometimes it's getting the rules rolling is the problem.
He's very intense.
Really?
That's not what she said.
Oh, you got your dad. You got your dad with it earlier.
Make sure that he can fight. He's got a date. If Hergovich, you know, like Trevor Bryan.
No. We didn't. This was a real fight. I did it. Be honest. And this was a fight.
Listen to this part right here. This is the part I was looking for.
You're talking about is the deal with no rematch. That was discussed on Monday. But anyway, look, I mean, it's very standard, and Dillian would ask for exactly the same thing in a voluntary defence. He knows that as well.
No, not really. We didn't, this was a real fight. I did it. Be honest. And this is a real fight.
I'm gonna delete this video, and I'm going to do a shorter video and talk about it tomorrow. But, Monday meaning. But, the $50 million offer, did you guys ever believe? Now, I know, you know, truth be told, honestly, Joshua's taking a big hit, man. Like, he don't have the same reputation he used to have. Like, behind, like, it seems like, you know, out in front of us, you know, he comes across as this well-spoken, you know, nice guy, always saying the right things. But behind the scenes, fighters are not saying good things about him. Did y'all notice that? Like, he's just, you know? Yo, what's up with this chick? Are you obsessed? Anyway.